Yes, right, fine. Thank you. We are starting. Welcome, friends. So I hereby present Dr. Sudhindr from UGC DACSR Mumbai. Over to you, sir.
Yeah. Thank you, Dr. Ajay Simalti, and very good morning to all of you. And it is my pleasure and privilege to invite you all for this online workshop on the awareness of the UGC DA Consortium for Scientific Research Facilities. And this program, as you know, is planned for 4 days. So you'll have a lot of lectures on the various facilities which are available on the consortium. So I hope it will be a very fruitful and useful workshop for all of us. And without much ado, I would like to invite Dr. Ajay Simalti, who has been working very hard to bring this workshop online. And I'll introduce Dr. Simalti and hand over to you to Dr. Simalti. Dr. Simalti, please.
सभी विद्वजनों को उत्तराखंड देवभूमि की पावन धरती से मेरा प्रणाम. और दिस इज द वेरी होली डे फॉर आवर स्टेट इटसेल्फ बिकॉज इट्स द स्टेट एस्टेब्लिशमेंट डे एंड वी आर सेलिब्रेटिंग द 21st एस्टेब्लिशमेंट डे ऑफ आवर स्टेट उत्तराखंड. सो वी वार्मली वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू फ्रॉम द लैंड ऑफ गॉड्स, फ्रॉम द लैंड ऑफ बद्री विशाल, फ्रॉम द लैंड ऑफ Baba Kedar, from the land of Ma Ganga or Ma Yamuna. So welcome, friends, in the UGC DACSR National Workshop on the Awareness Facilities. So in the outset, I would like to invite directly Dr. Vasudev Siruguri, Director UGC DACSR, about briefing the workshop. Then we will be moving with the plan. This is the awareness facility workshop. I invite Dr. V. Siruguri directly without wasting any time. Dr. Siruguri, very good morning, sir. And I hereby invite you. Please, sir.
Namaskar and good morning to everyone. Honorable Vice Chancellor, HNB Garhwal University, Professor Nautiyal. So I am Cell Coordinator, HNB Garhwal University, Dr. Ajay Simalti. My colleague and the coordinator of the workshop, Dr. Sudhindr Raiprol, are the resource persons for this workshop, and the participants. A very good morning to all of you. UGC DAE Consortium for Scientific Research is an autonomous institute of the University Grants Commission, and our main mandate is to provide all universities across the country and research institutions, especially the research students, access to the what are called the big science or mega science facilities of the Department of Atomic Energy. And these are typically like the Indus Synchrotron at Rajaramana Center for Advanced Technology at Indore, the National Facility for Neutron Beam Research at Dhruva Reactor, Mumbai, and the Variable Energy Cyclotron Center at Kolkata, and more recently some more material science and accelerator facilities at Indira Gandhi Center for Advanced Research, Kalpakkam. It has been the constant endeavor of our consortium to make sure that all researchers in every nook and corner of the country have access to the most modern and advanced research facilities, which are normally or usually very difficult to establish in various universities. So it is with this purpose that we try to hold workshops in each and every corner of the country. In fact, a few years ago, we have already organized one workshop at the Kumaon University in Uttarakhand. And we have also been to very north of the country. We have been to Jammu. Then we have also been to northeast several times. We have organized several workshops, as well as in the west and the south of the country. So with these kind of workshops, we try to encourage people in far-flung areas of the country to come and participate in research, and as well as participate in the development of facilities at various at our centers. In this process, we find that we have been fairly successful, or rather I should say modestly extremely successful, in bringing these facilities to all the research institutes and universities across the country. So in this process, we wanted to have, in fact, come to Uttarakhand again. But as you know, due to this pandemic, which is ongoing across the whole world, we are unable to do so. But this is the next best alternative for that. And so thankfully, because of the developments in all these online techniques and online facilities, we are able to still reach out across to far-flung areas and have access and make people aware about all our facilities. So in this regard, this workshop is being organized, and we hope to bring to the participants all the details about the various research facilities which are accessible for all the researchers across the country. And one very unique feature of our institute is that all of these facilities, access to these facilities is absolutely free of charge. And in fact, we provide funding for students especially to come to our centers and then carry out their experiments and go back. So we have fairly succeeded in this endeavor. And so we hope that with this workshop, we would be even more successful in bringing across these facilities to far-flung areas of the country. So and another unique feature has been that, especially in view of the fact that the Honorable Vice Chancellor is an expert on women empowerment, we have a large number of women students and women faculty who keep coming to our workshops as well as our centers to do their research, and they have very greatly benefited from our facilities. So with this, thank you very much for making it a point to participate in our workshop. And especially I would like to thank the Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Nautiyal, for taking time off from her busy schedule and then attending our inauguration of our workshop. Thank you very much again. Over to Dr. Simalti.
Due to some issues, thank you, Dr. Siriguri, for briefing about the workshop and about the UGCDA CSR workshop. What are the endeavors and what are the national responsibility with respect to the research being carried out by the UGCDA CSR? So I humbly invite Honorable Vice Chancellor Professor Annapurna Nautiyal, Vice Chancellor, HNB Garhwal University, which is the Central University, Srinagar Garhwal, Uttarakhand. Due to some technical reasons, she would be unable to connect with her camera. We will be able to hear her voice. I invite Annapurna Nautiyal, ma'am. Ma'am, please, if you can unmute your mic. Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Nautiyal.
Okay. Yeah, a very good morning to all of you. And as Professor Simalti has already said, that this is a very auspicious day that we have completed 20 years of our journey for Uttarakhand state. And it was a very long and journey full of ups and downs. And Uttarakhand was the result of a public movement, mass movement. Therefore, this day is celebrated with great joy, because it were the people who could bring it into a reality. So let me congratulate everyone through this forum who have fought for Uttarakhand and who are still doing tremendous work for the development and growth of Uttarakhand. So my congratulations and best wishes to everyone. And I would also like to welcome on behalf of HNV Garhwal University, the team of UGC DAE CSR program. I just heard Dr. Siriguri and Dr. Sudhendra, and I'm really very much interested as well as very happy to see that there is a program. Actually, it's a consortium for scientific research facilities, and I think this is the demand of the day, and we need such facilities immensely. And I am very, very, very happy because as Dr. Siriguri very aptly said that it's not possible to have these facilities everywhere, in every nook and corner of India or Indian universities. So if there is a pool of such facilities to expose the students, to expose the faculty, I think it's a very, very good move. And I would also like to congratulate UGC DAE consortium for this opportunity, for providing this chance to the students who want to chart their course in the stream of science. So I think it's a very good idea. And the second very good idea is access, because in the national education policy also we are talking about access and equity. So these kinds of facilities will definitely provide, or they are providing, access and equity to everyone. Like Dr. Siriguri talked about the women scientists and the women scholars. So he said that it's a kind of women empowerment, because the women faculty and research scholars are being benefited by this. And I think in the national education policy also, this goal is very well highlighted when this policy talks about gender inclusive fund or gender fund. So I think all these initiatives are very promising, and they will lead the country towards the path of progress and to develop scientific temper, about which the national education policy talks aloud. And of course, it also talks about that we have to stop the regimentation, the compartment of the educational streams, and we have to connect each and every stream, like STEM, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. They need to be connected with humanities, social sciences, arts, language, music, folk arts, and other subjects. So I think although this is a purely scientific program, but when you will invite other students also, I think they'll be interested, because you provide free facilities to the students. So if they can have the access, like a Dhruva reactor, if they can just go around, maybe their mind changes and they get tempted, they get hooked towards the scientific knowledge which they lack so far. And like you talked about the Indira Gandhi Center in Kalpakkam. So I think this exposure tour should be for all the students of all streams. Not necessarily that they will be trained on the equipments, but they should get a chance to see the facilities so that they can also develop a scientific temper. And scientific temper does not mean that it will lead you to only science, only doing science. scientific temper allows you to have curiosity, allows to have critical thinking, analytical capabilities. So if you give a exposure tour, if you expose the students to such facilities, irrespective of their stream, irrespective of their discipline, I think it will be a very fruitful effort in the part of UGC DAE consortium, because it is a consortium. And as you said that you have gone to all the directions, like east, west, north, south, all the directions to connect the students, to expose them. So my request to you would be, please try to connect students of all streams for their exposure, for their understanding, for their awareness, because it's an awareness program. And this awareness should go to the students of all disciplines, all streams. So it should become more equitable. It should become a level playing field for all students, so that they can be interested, or they can be part of such kind of programs. Like a national education policy has a certain goal that has been highlighted very much, that it intends to give education which can lead to research, and then that research can lead to innovation, and then that innovation can lead to extension or best practices. So I think through these initiatives like UGC, DAE consortium, or such kind of other platforms, this goal of connecting education with research, innovation, and extension can be completed. Because unless we go to the community, unless we go to the people, unless we bring a change into the human life, unless we bring a change into the way of their thinking, the aim will not be achieved. So this aim can be achieved through these kind of interventions which this consortium plans. And here I would also like to inform you that, because you talked about that you have gone all the corners of the country, and you had gone to Kumar University also, and Kumar University was benefited by this workshop, and you had gone to Jammu also, and you have gone to Northeast also. So I would also like to inform you that recently we have also constituted a consortium of 13 Indian Himalayan Central Universities, which are located in all over the Himalayas, and with a research institution, CSIR IHPT. Although the mandate of this consortium is fixed by the Niti Aayog, and they have given us a task to complete 5 thematic studies, which are primarily related to the humans of this area, like enumeration of female labor workforce, migration and livelihood connection between these, and eco-sustainable tourism development, water harvesting and conservation, and medicinal or agroecology aspect. So these are the mandate of that study, which we have to conduct within the span of 1 year. And this has been sponsored by Niti Aayog, and the UGC has already released funds, or it has given a sanction letter to release the funds to us. So we are also trying to connect the Himalayas. We are also trying to work towards one Himalaya, because the problems of the Himalayan people are similar in nature. Although there are geographical differences, there are differences of culture, there are differences of other rituals, but basically people are one. They suffer from the same miseries, they suffer from the same agonies, and their developmental problems are same as we face in Uttarakhand. The similarity is there. So this consortium also aims to connect people through education, through research, through innovation, and through extension. So I think the goal of this UGC DAE consortium is also same, and this is about to develop scientific temper and to expose the students towards the excellent facilities which has been developed by the scientific community, by the scientific societies. So I congratulate the organizer, Dr. Ajay Semalti, for taking up this very timely initiative to organize this workshop in HNV Garhwal University with the Association of UGC DAE Consortium. And I also congratulate the team UGC DAE for sparing their time to be in this workshop. Although I cannot, I can see all of you, but unfortunately you cannot see me. And this is also a scientific glitch, scientific or technological glitch, because I can hear everyone. But I'm sorry, because of some problem, I don't know, because this is happening for the first time. Otherwise, this has never happened before. Maybe there is some problem with our system. So systemic problems are everywhere. And it can be in a scientific institution also. It can be a institution of eminence also. It can be we saw it during the launch of a program that was very prestigious, and our Prime Minister was also watching it. But that also, there was also some glitch. So I think it keeps on happening. So please don't mind it, and don't think that Garhwal University is not a it has a very comfortable platform for these kind of programs. We have a very good platform, and Dr. Ajay Semalti is very competent enough to handle all these challenges. So if there is some problem, then I think we should own it, and I am owning it, that because of some problem, technical problem, this has happened. But my best wishes for this program, and I'm very sure that Dr. Ajay Semalti informed me that there are 1,018 participants in this program. So it's a huge number. It's a very good number. So if awareness could be generated through these programs, and 1,000 students could be made aware of these schemes, I think your task would be done, though slowly, but the message will reach to all the other stakeholders also, because good things happen slowly, but when they happen, they create a kind of revolution in the society. So this is to bring about a revolution in the society and to develop a scientific temper in the students, in the community, in the society, and which is required for the 21st century India, about which we are, all of us, all academicians, all administrators are talking, because we need to chart our path towards progress to become a knowledge power in the 21st century. And this can be done through such kind of programs only. So I congratulate and extend my warm wishes to each one of you for organizing this program, and also to Dr. Siriguri and Dr. Sudhendra for sparing their time to be with the students of HNV Garhwal University. And I think there would be some faculty members also who have joined it. So I welcome each one of you, and a very warm welcome to all of you, warm wishes. And once again, I extend my warm wishes for the establishment of Uttarakhand, and thank you very much. And namaste from my side. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Professor Nautiyal. It was very nice, kind words which you have spoken. And we definitely hope to incorporate all that you have suggested. And we already have certain possibilities of visits of students, university students, to these large scale facilities. And that can be also taken up as and when the problems regarding the pandemic recede. So we'll be back to the normal conditions. We'll definitely look into your suggestions, and which are very useful and important. And we again, I take this opportunity to thank you for sparing your time and addressing us. And also, I would like to extend my very warm wishes for the Uttarakhand Day. And I now hand over to Professor Semalti for the further program.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Dr. Semalti, you're not audible. Mic.
Thanks a lot, Honorable Vice Chancellor, for the kind words and for her blessings. And hope with the good mix, with a good heterogeneous group of participants from each and every field. It was I was going through the statistics. So almost 20% are from physics, 25% from pharmacy, to almost 25% from life sciences and engineering, biomedical. So it's a very heterogeneous group we are having, and that too in terms of faculty members, research scholars, students. A huge mass of participants is from faculty members. So I hope all the participants will get the benefit out of the workshop. So friends, without wasting the time, we would like to start our technical session directly. The first session will be taken by the Dr. V. Siruguri. He is the officiating director of UGCDA-CSR, and he is the director of UGCDA-CSR Mumbai Center in the Bhabha Atomic Research Center campus, BRC campus. So without any further delay, I humbly invite Dr. Siruguri for his address. Welcome, sir.
Yeah.
So before he starts, with the permission of everyone, I would like to leave.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you very much.
It was very nice seeing you, although you could not see me, but I could see you. And a very warm welcome to all of you again. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. We'll definitely make it a point to visit Uttarakhand University as soon as possible. Thank you so much.
You're most welcome. Let the corona over, and then you are most welcome to physically visit Uttarakhand. As you have already assured that you'll think about my idea, because presently we are only thinking about science background students. So we should think about exposing to the students of other discipline also.
Sure.
That's the goal of national education policy of ending fragmentation, regimentation. So this can be done only through these kinds of mix and match approaches. So thank you very much for taking it seriously. Namaskar. Thank you. Namaskar.
Dhanyavaad ma'am, samay nikalne ke liye bahut bahut dhanyavaad ma'am. Pranam.
Thank you. Have a nice day.